Good morning and a very warm welcome to our service of morning prayer on this the 16th Sunday after Pentecost. Blessed be God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom now and forever. Amen.
Come, let us worship God our King.
Come, let us worship Christ, our King and our God.
Lord God, our Maker and Redeemer, this is your world and we are your people. Come among us and save us. We have misused your gifts of creation and have regarded them as nothing more than resources for us to exploit. Look with mercy on your people.
And forgive us.
We have seen the ill treatment of others and have not gone to their aid. Look with mercy on your people.
And forgive us.
We have not loved you with all our heart, nor our neighbors as ourselves. Look with mercy on your people.
And forgive us.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God rules over all the earth.
O come, let us worship.
Glorify the Lord, all you works of the Lord.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
Let the earth glorify the Lord.
Glorify the Lord, O mountains and hills.
And all that grows upon the earth.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
Glorify the Lord, O springs of water, seas, and streams.
O whales and all that move in the waters.
All birds of the air, glorify the Lord.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
Glorify the Lord, O beasts of the wild.
And all you flocks and herds.
O men and women everywhere, glorify the Lord.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
Let us glorify the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord.
Praise him and highly exalt him forever.
God rules over all the earth.
O come, let us worship.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The whole congregation of the Israelites complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. For you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I am going to rain bread from heaven for you, and each day the people shall go out and gather enough for that day. In that way, I will test them, whether they will follow my instruction or not. On the sixth day, when they prepare what they bring in, it will be twice as much as they gather on other days." So Moses and Aaron said to all the Israelites, "In the evening, you shall know that it was the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt, And in the morning you shall see the glory of the Lord, because he has heard your complaining against the Lord. For what are we that you complain against us? And Moses said, when the Lord gives you meat to eat in the evening and your fill of bread in the morning, because the Lord has heard the complaining that you utter against him, what are we? Your complaining is not against us, but against the Lord. Then Moses said to Aaron, say to the whole congregation of the Israelites, draw near to the Lord, for he has heard your complaining. And as Aaron spoke to the whole congregation of the Israelites, they looked towards the wilderness, and the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, I have heard the complaining of the Israelites. Say to them, at twilight you shall eat meat, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord your God. In the evening, quails came up and covered the camp, and in the morning there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there on the surface of the wilderness was a fine, flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to one another, what is it? For they did not know what it was. Moses said to them, it is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A portion of Psalm 105. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name.
Make known his deeds among the peoples.
Sing to him, sing praises to him.
And speak of all his marvelous works.
Glory in his holy name.
Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Search for the Lord and his strength.
Continually seek his face.
Remember the marvels he has done.
His wonders and the judgments of his mouth.
O offspring of Abraham, his servant.
O children of Jacob, his chosen.
He led out his people with silver and gold.
And all their tribes, there was not one that stumbled.
Egypt was glad of their going.
Because they were afraid of them.
He spread out a cloud for a covering.
And a fire to give them light in the night season.
They asked, and quails appeared.
And he satisfied them with bread from heaven.
He opened the rock, and water flowed.
So that the river ran in dry places.
For God remembered his holy word.
And Abraham his servant.
So he led forth his people with gladness.
His chosen with shouts of joy.
He gave his people the lands of the nations.
And they took the fruit of others' toil.
That they might keep his statutes.
And observe his laws. Hallelujah.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Still the moonlight, and fear the twinkling stars.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire men to work in his vineyard. He agreed to pay them a denarius for the day and sent them into his vineyard. About the third hour, he went out and saw others standing in the marketplace doing nothing. He told them,
"You also go and work in my vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right."
So they went. He went out again about the sixth hour and the ninth hour and did the same thing. About the 11th hour, he went out and found still others standing around. He asked them,
"Why have you been standing here all day long doing nothing?"
"Because no one has hired us,"
they answered. He said to them,
"You also go and work in my vineyard."
When evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman,
"Call the workers and pay them their wages, beginning with the last ones hired and going on to the first."
The workers who were hired about the 11th hour came and each received a denarius. So when those came who were hired first, they expected to receive more. But each one of them also received a denarius. When they received it, they began to grumble against the landowner.
"These men who were hired last worked only 1 hour,"
they said,
"and you have made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the work and the heat of the day."
But he answered one of them,
"Friend, I'm not being unfair to you. Didn't you agree to work for a denarius? Take your pay and go. I want to give the man who was hired last the same as I gave you. Don't I have the right to do what I want with my own money? Or are you envious because I'm generous?"
So the last will be first, and the first will be last.
The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of my lips and the meditations of all our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen.
Amen. Read recently of a lovely conversation between two clergy colleagues. The mother of one of the colleagues had passed away recently, left her with the unenviable task of cleaning out the family home. Some of you know what that's like. Providentially, she ran into another woman who ran an estate sales company. This woman simply instructed her, "Go through the house and take only what you want. Take all the time you need, then leave the rest to us. We will take care of it." Now that invitation had a huge impact on the cleric. Her saying those words to me was the most wonderful act of grace, she confided to her colleague. "I felt such relief. It allowed me to grieve my mother without the burden of the rest." Taking simply what we need and sharing the rest. The tagline in the Season of Creation Materials from South Africa for this third Sunday in the season is, "God provides for our need, not our greed." It's what Yahweh demonstrated to the people of Israel through the miraculous feeding in the wilderness and the reading from Exodus. God is a God who cares deeply and is deeply concerned for our well-being. The God who feeds the people of Israel is the same God who promised to be with Moses and the people at the burning bush, as we heard 3 weeks ago. And this God is the same God who showed his amazing care at the Passover. and again at the crossing of the Red Sea we listened to last week. Yahweh now saves Israel from starvation by sending them manna, their daily bread. And it's not just about the food. Yahweh provides this miraculous meal to remind the people of his presence with them and deep compassion for them. Yahweh is a God who provides for our need, whatever our particular need might be. And it's not as though Yahweh only responds because of the Israelites' good behavior. On the contrary, the story this morning begins with their belly aching. It's a recurring theme throughout the stories of their wandering in the wilderness. If Yahweh intended to kill us, they cry out, why not in Egypt, where at least our bellies were full? And it's not as if their whinging finishes here. The people of Israel complain about the lack of water. They moan about Moses marrying a foreigner. They grumble over the leadership of Moses and Aaron. Now it's all too easy for us to write off the people of Israel as a bunch of ungrateful so-and-sos. After all, I mean, Yahweh has brought them out of slavery in Egypt with not just one, but a series of miracles. Yahweh's now leading them in a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night through the wilderness into the promised land, providing for their every need. Only they'd sooner whinge than worship. On the other hand, don't these ancient grumblings have an all too familiar ring? Almost seems part of our national identity as Canadians to moan about the weather. We read far too often of those who complain about immigrants in our midst. And we too grumble about our leaders, don't we? Only notice how Yahweh responds to the hunger of the wandering wilderness whiners. God doesn't berate them for their subpar attitude. God doesn't blame them for losing sight of the bigger picture. God doesn't badger them about their need to buck up. God's people are hungry. So God feeds them quail in the evening and manna in the morning. And as many commentators note, quail and manna are naturally occurring phenomena in the Middle East. Quail migrate from Africa to Egypt and often settle to rest at night en route. Tamarisk trees secrete a substance each morning resembling the description of manna. A manna, incidentally, is a word derived from the Hebrew manhu, which simply means, what is it? God responds immediately to the hunger of God's people in natural and supernatural ways. Only God provides for their need and not for their greed. As we later discover in the section of the story beyond this morning's appointed reading, those who gathered much had nothing over, and those who gathered little had no shortage. They gathered as much as each of them needed. Moses warns them not to hang on to any of the manna overnight. They're not to hoard it. Some, of course, pay no heed to Moses, only to discover that their precious stockpile has bred worms and become foul. Need, not greed. And one of the lessons God is teaching the Israelites in the wilderness is that God provides, and generously. They've left the rule of Pharaoh and Egypt, one of oppression and scarcity, for the reign of God. In the wilderness and the promised land, one of empowerment and abundance. What they're needing to learn, as we still do today, is that in God, there's always enough. Only God is one who provides for our need and not our greed. What the Israelites discover in the wilderness is that in order for there to be enough, they need to share. What they hoard ends up going bad. It's true for us today, as it was for the people of God back then. One of the temptations for us in the season of creation is to succumb to the slough of despair. Last week, a major report by the conservation group World Wildlife Fund identified a catastrophic decline in wildlife populations. More than two-thirds of the wildlife population has disappeared in less than 50 years, even as we waste 1.3 billion tons of food each year. God's promise to each and every one of us this morning is that even in the wilderness of a pandemic and climate crisis, there's always enough in Christ. Provided we learn to take only what we need and to share the rest. We may not have had to clean out a parent's home to discover the freedom and the joy that there is in simply taking what we need and sharing the rest. Just ask those who supported the food bank and SPCA yesterday at the drive-thru. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray.
Holy God, Lord of compassion and gracious understanding, we come with an openness to express our concerns for the Church and the world, and to thank you for your goodness. Lord God, when the Church joins together, we can show people a much fuller picture of Jesus and his kingdom. We pray for your churches and ask that there will be a growing desire to get together. We give you thanks for those who come up with fresh ways of making your name known to the wider community, and for those who work so hard to make worship possible through online and virtual services. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creator God, we pray for our world where through television we see the misery and tragedy brought about by wrong choices. We pray for wisdom and compassion in all negotiations and discussions taken by our world and local leaders. We ask that there be humility in leadership and responsibility for right actions shared by all. And we particularly pray that this may apply to all things associated with the pandemic. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father God, help and guide our schools, colleges, and universities as they begin a new school year, especially with all their concerns about the coronavirus and how they will cope with social distancing but still be together and learn with and from one another. May their teachers inspire a love of learning for its own sake and kindle joy in all subjects and help them to grow into caring and knowledgeable adults. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father God, forgive us when we waste our lives by being too busy to enjoy your creation. Teach us how to make spaces in the day to do the things we most enjoy. Just as you rested from your work, help us to practice the discipline of recreation and help us to become your hands and feet in our community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, help those we know and love to turn away from habits which are harmful to them. Help them to turn to you in times of crisis rather than reaching for quick fix solutions. Lord, we also bring to you those we know who are ill or suffering in any way. Give them healing and restore them in body, mind, and spirit. We especially pray for Doug, Dwayne, Elaine, Marg, Sherry, Ray, Carol, Owen and family, Jane, Dave, Mary Rose, Jose, Evelyn, Ella, Malcolm, John, Nathan and family, Barb, all those on our long-term prayer list, and those known to each of us alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Mighty God, give us ears to hear and minds to understand the message of immortality for the children of your kingdom, so that we may look forward with patience and confidence to that time when we will join you in the peace of eternity. We especially pray for any we know who recently died and are on that journey to you. Thank you for them, and thank you for your promise of eternal life and peace. Be close to those who are recently bereaved. Strengthen them with the knowledge that you are always there to lean on and to be carried through difficult times. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Faithful God, at the start of this new week, help us to be an example to others and show us the practical steps we need to take to develop consistency and integrity in all that we do in our lives. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
O God, from your providing hand, even the dissatisfied and grumbling receive what they need for their lives. Teach us your ways of justice and lead us to practice your generosity so that we may live a life worthy of the gospel made known through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
God of all that is, free us from the fear of insufficiency and the clamor to possess. Make us generous in the abundance of your love, and deepen us in the understanding that in Christ enough has been given. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us sing as our Savior taught us.
Mm-hmm.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go forth in the hope in which you have been saved. Praise God in all creation. Follow Christ, through whom all things are made whole. In the power of the Spirit, become a beacon of hope to the world. And the blessing of the Creator God, the Eternal Father, the risen Son, and the promised Holy Spirit bless you, that you might be a blessing to others today and always.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, sir. Love and serve the Lord.